this week, man, and guide me for 45 minutes, man, to show me what God's love is about.
Amen.
Right.
I know he's not going to share anything, but this, I told him this that day. I'm talking to the man that has been through so many valleys in his life. There's so many that he can go on, but I don't know what he's going to talk about today, but I thank you. Thank you for that talk today, man. The other day, it really helped me. And you were a key guy this week, man, and walking me through it, right? God bless you. Palenque Rodriguez, guys.
Amen. Opportunity to speak before you, men. I take it so serious.
Amen.
I went into the bathroom on the other side of the building over there, and I came walking back out the corridor, man, the hallway, and man, I felt like I was on the way to the ring. Because I'm going to come and get down today, and I've been getting ready to get down today for the honor and glory of the Lord Jesus Christ, because that's who we serve,
amen.
That's who we love.
Amen.
The weapons of our warfare are not carnal but mighty through God by the pulling down of strongholds, taking into captivity every thought, every imagination, every stinking imagination that exalts itself against His word. Even right now, your minds are bouncing all over the place. Why? We don't got the discipline. We haven't disciplined ourselves like true warriors of the Lord Jesus Christ with that helmet of salvation. Look at a lot of us. I talk to some people and say, I know. Whether they got a PhD or whether they got a pastory. And I know. And God bless everyone here. But at the end of the conversation, I say, okay, what do you do with what you know?
Come on now.
That's when I stump the stars.
Amen.
It's just kind of ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma-ma. Because what do you do? What do we do?
Come on.
We're here today, guys. We're here to get our quenches pumped up a little.
Come on, champ.
Get in my way. But we're in the gym right now, you guys.
Amen.
Yes, we are. Let's get it straight. And we go to any of the pastors, and Pastor Nati came all the way from Santa Ana, and I see Nico in the back. And I feel so privileged, man, to get the opportunity. So much has happened. I'm so excited about what God's doing with great anticipation in the midst of every circumstance, every storm.
That's
right. The Lord gave me a new wife 3 years ago. I just celebrated 3 years, glory. She's my wife. I love her, man. I put her first. Because that's her place. That's her place of honor in my life.
Hallelujah.
But I know what it is to lose, too, you guys.
That's right.
Amen.
For those of us that have had any type of exposure, we're targets, man. People know who you are. You don't know who they are. The enemy lurks in the closet. He's that angel of light. He's sneaky.
Yeah.
And you're out there banging the boards for the Lord. And you don't know sometimes where it's going to come from. And I remember coming on Larry King Live. It was me, Bo Taylor, and NFL great Jim Brown. And we're talking about gang violence.
Wow.
See, you guys, I didn't raise my hand to say I want to deal with gang violence. It wasn't my decision. The Lord took me to the Y and they killed my son. 3 days after I buried him, he took me there, man. I was driving up from the Black Angus. After a meeting with three businessmen, because we had the Jet Center, we dealt with people from all levels of the social and economic ladder. We did movies there. We had it going on. And I'm driving. After that meeting in Charlie, was still on the air back then. And that song, Sun and Heaven for the Sunshine You Gave. Well, that was my son's song. That was his name, Sun. The Lord said, go. I didn't even see the name of the town. He told me to go to, but he told me to go. As I'm driving, I'm going, wow, why am I going here? I hit the train tracks to go to the tracks. The Spirit of God fell on me. And he says, I want you to bind the spirit of murder and violence over this city. The principalities, the rulers, the darkness of the unseen world, and the wicked in high places. The spirit of murder and violence. And I drove, and I came to a corner, and I made a right. And I came around to the small corner, and boom, right there. And I'm in a suit, because I was there on a business meeting. I was a contingency of 10, 15 young guys, man. And right there, the Spirit of God starts speaking to me. They start standing up like, who's this guy?
Christ.
He says, a parole officer, probation, is he a cop, who is he? And I'm looking, and then the Spirit of God says, the love starts with them. And that's how this work with birth, you guys.
Amen.
It's not, the Lord is not looking for the strongest, the handsomest, the best that can speak the best. He's looking for the available. Amen. Who's available? Amen. Who will stand up for you? Who can have the boldness and the courage to be able to speak for the Lord is being ready in and out of season. And so, when God spoke that to me, you seen it. There was this whole thing that we had to forgive, and we had to forgive as a marriage, evenly yoked in the Word. And so we forgave. Now let me say this to you: I don't know who in here needs to forgive. I don't know who in here needs to step to that challenge that we hear about day in day out. Forgive them, Lord, for they know not what they've done, because that's what He said to me in the courtroom every step of the way. When I stepped in and all them gente that were there, including the three guys that killed my kid, and they're looking at me like I'm a piece of garbage. Wow. And this hatred that starts growing from my feet up my legs, up my thighs, starting to choke me. And I take that next step, and the Spirit of God says, forgive them, for they know not what they're doing. Every step, forgive them, for they know not what. All the way to the front row. And one guy, he kept looking. I'm looking back at him. And the Holy Spirit arrests me right there. And this whole seed of forgiveness manifested itself. Because it's not what we know, it's what we do with what we know.
Amen.
When are we going to stand up? Men of God! Men of God! Mama will bless you all. Come on, man.
Man.
We got the choice to make decisions every single day. Conscientious decisions. And be strategic in our attack. We, the men. The body of Christ. I'm sorry, man, but you go to the church and the women are doing everything.
Come on now.
The Lord is saying, I'm looking for a man. The priest of the home. The one that I'm going to hold accountable if it goes wrong and that bad. Amarrate. That's what the Lord says, not me. What are we going to do? Are we going to keep whack? Are we going to talk? Are we going to walk it? It's going to happen, you guys. We got to rise up no matter where we're at. Not way that's abusive, not in a way that is condescending, not in a way that it's just cutting people up with the word and leaving them bleeding right there on the ground and walking over them.
Amen.
No, man, with the compassion and the spirit of the living God that speaks to the heart of men. I had a unique situation happen to me last week. I go get gas and there's a homeless cat, man. Can I pump gas? You know, I got the gas. Don't worry about it. But I, you know, I had $2 in my pocket. One of those days, you know. Didn't get a chance to stop and pick up my regular 20. And you know, the Spirit of God's going to say something. I'm going to give him $1. Hey, look, come here. Hey, man, here you go. I said, you know, God bless you. God bless you. But then he goes to ask this other cat, can I pump gas for you? And the guy don't even say, look at him. So I look at him and I say, hey, do you know who the Lord is? And he goes, yeah. I go, what's his name?
Oh.
And we're standing a good ways away from him. I said, hey, do you know who the Lord is? And he goes, yeah. I said, what's his name? He says, Jesus. I go, who? He says, Jesus. I can't hear you. He said, Jesus. I said, you know what? You get my second dollar, man. Here's my second dollar. So then at the end of the day, I'm already coming home. I already made the call to my beautiful wife. How you doing, baby? Everything good to go. Hope you had a good day. And I stopped here at Holiday Burgers. How many know Holiday Burgers? They got ferocious, right? Sandwiches and everything. And there's a homeless cat. And he's just staring and staring and staring. So, you know, I get my order. I'm good to go. As I'm getting in the car, the Lord says, I turn around. I go to him and he says, they got great pastrami sandwiches here. The jumbo fries. I said, look, I don't know about the jumbo fries, all right? But you're getting a pastrami sandwich. I go back to Holiday Burger and I said, look, give me pastrami, give me some fries, man. Give me a large orange whip. And the young man is doing the transaction, is saying, he's telling me, thank you, man, thank you. He's thanking me for buying this guy something to eat. So meanwhile, he looks back over at the other cooks, before you know it, this guy's trying to wrap a dang pastrami sandwich up and the paper won't fit. They got so much pastrami in the sandwich. Hey, literally, I'm God is my witness. I'm dying if I'm lying. So they finally get another foil, put another foil on. And then the woman's putting the fries in, and then she's putting more scoops of papas in there, man.
Come on now.
And so, come out. I said, here, man, you got your jumbo fries.
Amen.
You got your pastrami. But when I come out, he's gibbering. He's gibbering. First, then he fades in and out. And then I said to him, hey, look at me, man. Look at me. And he looked at me and I said, Jesus is Lord.
Hallelujah.
And he stopped gibbering and he goes. And then he starts gibbering. As I'm walking away from him now, again, it's another parking lot, man. And I'm saying, there's power in the blood of Jesus. There's power in the blood of Jesus. There's power in the blood of Jesus. And I'm getting in the car. There's power in the blood of Jesus. And that was the way I started my day and ended my day. You guys, God is on the move in the San Fernando Valley. I know not, he's on the move in Santa Ana too. Because he's omnipresent everywhere all the time.
Amen.
He cannot do.
Amen.
The revival has to come in the men. And the only way it's going to come is going to be when our hearts ignite for him.
Amen.
You know the fire I'm talking about, brother?
Amen.
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 It's just the truth.
Fire.
So who ignites it? I said, this is the gym. That is the gym.
Amen.
Matter of fact, when you go to the sanctuary, it's holy ground.
Amen.
It's the gym.
You reach it.
Huh? To sharpen the fierro.
Oh,
amen. To exalt, to edify, to build up.
Yes.
That's the word. That's what the word says.
Amen.
But it's not the arena. How many remember a fighter named Bobby Chapuano?
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, Bobby, the great Bobby Chacon, the late Bobby Chacon. I was his best man twice. Third time I told him I'm Jinx. Yeah. There was a Japanese guy named Kurosawa. Kurosawa was a Japanese kickboxer, but he loved boxing. Bobby Chacon was his number one fan. He loved Bobby Chacon. He would come once a year for a month, and I would train him at the gym. And people would come from near and far, you guys. That gym you seen? The Lord showed me that dream, that in a dream in Tokyo, Japan, in Shinjuku, at the hotel. That's right, Kyo Plaza Hotel. And when I went downstairs, I didn't even think about the dream. I was one of those that would dream and not think about it. I dreamt Big D getting saved in 1978, long before I ever yoked up with him. Just the truth. If I'm lying or I'm dying. And so he came, and I was going to take him to go see Bobby Chacon train. Man, we were excited, but I go get him at LAX, and how many know the 405? Well, by the time we get to the gym, Bobby's already sparring. Bobby's got a big old headgear on and look like a German tank kind of thing, and Bobby's head's going like this. Bobby Chacon was not a gym fighter. This guy's touching. There's guys in the gym that are gym champions in the gym. They're touching up the champions in the gym.
Right.
Things can't do it in the arena. That's the problem. That's the problem, you guys.
Oh, wow.
We gotta step out at the edge of the branch. We gotta quit hugging the tree, man, so the guy can show himself. So that there can be miracles and wonders, you guys. He's waiting on us. I'm telling you the truth, man. You don't gotta get excited. Just let it hit your heart. Think about it when you're leaving. Even right now, your minds are bouncing. Some of you are thinking, man, this guy needs to quit yelling. And that's okay. And some people say, this guy's mad. I'm not mad. I'm not mad. I love the Lord. I'm just passionate for the kingdom of God.
Thank
you,
sir.
Thank you, guys.
Give up.
There's so much going on that it's hard to capture. I got 37 full-time staff. When we started this work, there was nothing. The Lord told me, go ahead, leave the jet center behind. We went to the water, they killed my son, and started a beef treaty. Wow. Me and Big D, Donald Garcia. Father, es como un vivo, baby. Understand me, huh? Huh? Right, Albert? How was that? A comrade. The Lord yoked me up with him, and people would say, what are you doing with him? He's faking it. Why with him, man? The Lord yoked me up with him and went to the parking. That one meeting turned into a meeting every Sunday for over a year. And the spirit of the living. There was no contracts. There was no intervention, nothing. There was nobody talking about Latin lives on the floors dying, man. Nobody. We're pre-stars, pre-bridges. Now it's the GRID program, gang reduction, youth development. And it's at the request of every mayor, every different administration that God has taken me through. We used to storm City Hall, man. Why? Because there was no justice. And the Lord that we serve is about justice.
Amen.
He is about the needs of broken people. He is about the least of all. The lepers that nobody wants to touch.
Amen.
Nobody wants to give no time to. Why? Because it's, man, it is labor intensive, man. And then the spirit of murder and violence. There was no yellow tape protocol. We used to follow the helicopters around here in the 90s, man. And show up there and the homicide detectives be looking at us like we were like, God made a way because God gives his favor. The favor he gave Joseph, you guys, is the favor he gives us.
Amen.
And he'll give it to you. I promise you, man.
Amen.
This city has to implode from the inside. Boom!
And from the outside.
Boom!
Come on.
And that was the strategy. When I was standing in the water that killed my son against the wall with 76 volumes represented in there from this bayou. Some of you know what was taking place because on the inside they didn't like it either. And I'm real careful what I say about the inside because that's not my lane. I walk up on the edge of the line don't step over it, because I know what God has given favor. God has given covering. You guys, a lot of people don't know the nature of what God's allowed us to build, the capacity, the unions that are giving gainful employment to the least of them. The tattoo removal, it's pro bono. The five major learning institutions that we've been doing internships with for the last 20 years. Again, the Coalition on Gangs at Church on the Way. The very room that we used to have gang members sitting in is the very rooms now that once a month, that is a whole coalition of LAUSD, Redmond Parks, Department of Human Services, Children's Services, LAPD, Probation, men of God. And I challenge and invite anybody, every first Thursday, that you go right up there, and that thing is 20 years old. I'm talking about consistency. If anything speaks to God's hand, there'll be continuity in it from the inception. And as I looked at that right now, the reminisce, man, Lord, take me back to the place, Lord. I can be broken before you. I just want to serve you. It's such an honor and a privilege, man, to be able to go before the Lord your God, to be able to come before you guys, and my mind's all over the place. Spirit of the
living God.
Oh, fresh. This is not just another day. This is the day that you have made. Oh, man. For me. Oh, I got a letter from Mike Moore. For those of you that don't know that name, he's the chief of police of the whole city of LA. He's just the new guy that came in. Personally inviting me to this event that they're having for Cesar Chavez over in La Plaza de la Raza today. And I'm like, when I got it, I said, I can't go. And I'm thinking in my mind, I can't go because I'm going to come and speak to some men of God today, man. I have an engagement already. My son, there might be one or two here that goes, huh? Chief of police. David, Daniel dealt with different facets of society. Joseph dealt with different facets of society. And God's allowed me to go to the high places. And God's allowed me to keep my feet planted firmly on the ground. Where the need is, the advocacy. We go to court with young people. We go in front of the judges. It's so much over the hall. And we plead for them. And we get them released to us and we send them to Colorado Springs, to Estes Park, Colorado, where they get a $100,000 scholarship. Little chavalones that are going to hurt somebody or get hurt. So I'm just sharing with you right now a little bit of the capacity and the structure of what's been put in place. Because God has given us influence. And how do we steward the influence that we have? Those of you in this room, brother, the influence that you have, the influence that we have in the communities that we're blessed to serve. Amen. Can we use it to the, it's like cash. It's like our stewarding of our dollars and how we spend our dollars, you guys. I'm believing God wants to explode here in the San Fernando Valley, because he has shown me that the light that is set on the hill shall not be hid. This is way back at the beginning when I was standing up against the wall, looking at all these dudes from all these lodges, and thinking, if I speak, what am I going to say? And then the Spirit of God said, talk to them about forgiveness. And I'm like, man, really? And he said, you lived it. It was in the paper, the mercy you gave the one, and he only got 2 years. Mm. And the forgiveness you gave to all of them. And so when I had my chance to speak, I began to speak to them about the power of forgiveness. Man. You see, you guys, amen. I don't have all the answers, but the God I serve does. And I got out here in the desert, man. 30 years, man. 30 years since that calling came. 30 years, well, 29 and a half, you guys. But my question to you, you, and because this day is took up some of the time showing that DVD, because I wanted to give some context from where we came. Why? Because God gave us enough wisdom to know we needed covering. And that's why Sonny Arians only came to be there. And that's why Jack Hayford spoke the words he spoke, because they put the covering over us. We're crazy, but we're not fools.
Hallelujah.
And then God began to give the increase. Then those four events, that first one was the Project Boys playing violin. We had one with all of our medals at Paxton Park. And all the dudes from San Fernando, there was over 400 guys in the park. And we didn't get rated. We've done over 200 sporting events with Rival Lobos, as quiet as it's kept, and never been rated. Who is that? That is the spirit of the living God. That is the power of God. And all the insane function, and all that, all the punitive, all the lock them up, all the industrial prison complex with the interstate exchange, man, the commodities they made out of lives, our people's lives. About business, but we can't get past our pride. Pride comes before a fall, and great is the fall. Great, man. But we're not, man. We ain't letting this go, we ain't letting that go. I'm that guy. We ain't got nothing. Remember that pastor came and spoke about for those of us that have been with the Lord a long time and we think we got it, and we don't got anything. Those of you that know that my son was gone 37 years, he's been out now 4 months.
Amen.
And God kept them whole for you. God kept them complete. It's all right. Because I know there's people in here that have been there and done that and overdone it. But now God is giving you a chance to represent him. Now is the time. Now is the time. I want to talk to you about this time that we're in. The Lord. I want to talk about the Lord's first order before he started his ministry. After John the Baptist baptized him, that was his cousin, by the way. Most of you know that. Yeah. And when the Lord came up out of the water, he had the heavens open. And the Father said, "This is my Son in whom I am well pleased." And a dove was released. And there was a mass of people there. And the Lord came up out of the water, and immediately the Spirit took him to the desert to fast for 40 days. 40 days, right? All of us know that story. Now, he went there and fasted and then was tempted of Satan before he did any order of ministry, before he made the lame to walk, before he caused the blind to see, anything, he went and fasted. So what are we waiting for? We can't handle watching the commercial on TV. Oh man, I'm hungry. I'm hungry. We're always hungry. Our flesh is always hungry for what's not of God. I'm just saying, God gives us in his word all of the armor of God.
Amen.
The armor of God. Ephesians 6. Come on. You guys know what I'm talking about. Do we want to get down or do we want to be gym fighters? I'm serious, man. I throw my life out there. I lay it on the line. People don't know what had to be dealt with out there. Dealing with violence. It ain't no secret that the guys inside don't want to see no violence out here and they're putting pressure. But then God is saving them too. Because God is not the respecter of persons. Everybody's on his list for salvation. But he wants to raise up a people, a man that is willing to humble himself before the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's a powerful season we're in. So this whole notion of fasting, making way. You've got to make weight. No, man, it's not about losing weight. It's about feeding the spirit, you guys. Breaking up, tearing up strongholds. Rompe las cadenas. Break the chains, break the chains, break the chains. Let revival come, Lord, let it come. Let revival come. Let it ignite right here in the valley, my God. Let it go. Look at all the sown seed. There's such a harvest, bro. It's already sown. Look at the faithfulness, of Brew Line. But when my guys and some of them are here, every morning we have a circle. Because I'm the CEO of the company, and I can say we're going to pray. Amen. I don't care about separation of church and state.
Amen.
It doesn't matter. And then we got people that are social workers that work for this young Latino that grew up right here in San Fernando, raised by a mother with 9 of us by herself. But that's how good God is. My grandmother came to this church. I ran to an altar call at 5 years old in this church. not even knowing what I was doing. As I see my cousin Carlos right here, you guys seen him out here, he was dancing like David danced. Where'd you cuss? And he's got a bad hip. That's the mouth of him from over there. Cooch out with the hip. The weapons of the warfare are not carnal, guys. Please, please focus for just 1 second, man. God wants to do something in this valley. I believe it with all my heart.
Hallelujah.
The dam's getting ready to bust. He showed me a dam. And on this side of the dam was a valley that was dry and desolate with fruit trees and all kinds of, but no irrigation. And it's been 30 years now of setting up the infrastructure. God's had us at peculiar tables, you guys. And for those of you that also within the context of where you work and whatever influence you have, see, ministry is meeting the needs of people. Amen. But if I know a union president and another union steward over here, how am I helping the least of them? How are we when men come here that they're going to lose their house or they're getting ready to have their water power shut off or too proud to say anything? It's that we're going to connect them. And the church, outside the four walls of the church, there's different churches here. And so we've been praying for pastors across the valley, guys. Pastors that got heavy yokes on them. Pastors, man, that are just carrying loads, man. How about the suicides that were going on for a while with pastors? And then we got our own problems, huh? Because, oh, I mean, man, I walked in here, I was like this today. You couldn't see me in the spirit. I was, but then the anointing comes and it turns into, let's get down. Yeah. At the end of the day, we're going to get down. I don't care what I'm thinking, we're going to get down. Because the Spirit of God is going to influence and He's going to begin to move the mountains. And that's what's going on right now.
That's
right. So that's it, you guys. There's so much. But God is consistent.
Yes.
Got the same consistency here. The same consistency with CIS. Matter of fact, we're changing our name from communities and schools to champions in service.
Yes. Amen.
The same acronym, CIS.
Conquer it.
So God's allowed us to go to the high places, you guys. I got staff, man, that go to meetings. Pastor Rudy was in meetings. Ed, I mean, you know, just it's incredible. God said, I'll take the foolish things of the world and confound the wise. How much more foolish than us can it get? But we've got to get an appetite. Look, I opened this thing up. I say, love your wives.
Wow,
I mentioned something about being on their team live. I've been on a lot of stuff. Footage, I got hours of footage people never seen. That's just part of the evidence. Because, you know, people want paperwork. You got paperwork? And then they got this new term, yeah, called evidence-based. It's just whose evidence? Usually it's the evidence of the hypothesis. The PhD, they sometimes, don't get mad at me, but sometimes I told them, you know what, your PhD is piled higher than people. Because it's not relevant to the people we're serving. Because it talks down to the people we're serving. The least of all. That's the truth. Matter of fact, our good friend Billy Graham, I went to the White House. Yeah, I've been to the White House. I've been to the United Nations, won an award in the United Nations. Am I going to boast? I'm boasting. And I ain't going to be afraid to boast.
Amen.
I give God all the honor, all the glory, all the praise.
Because
He took my young, young cat and He took me all over the world, man. And He let me see things that a normal kid from the bottom never gets to see. But I'm here because I'm humble before the Lord. And I want to serve Him if it's one person or 1,000 or 10,000.
Praise God.
So I get to the White House. And Billy Graham's giving this story. He gives this story about these guys that used to go once a year to go get a fox at this big farm. And every year they get this dog called Preacher. And Preacher would get them a fox. So for about 3 years they didn't go. Then they decided to go. When they get there, they notice as they're driving in, the fences are all painted. And they come driving up into the compound, and everything's looking bright and shiny. And they walk in, and they say to the gentleman that's at the counter, we'd like to get that dog Preacher. And I says, Preacher? We don't have a dog named Preacher. And these guys are saying, you had that dog, with white, brown spots on it. And so the guy was cleaning the kennels as they're walking out of the door. Says, hey, I heard you asking for that there dog Preacher. They go, yeah. He goes, we still have that dog, except we changed his name to Doctor, and he ain't been any good ever since. There's room for everything.
Amen.
But we got to know where the calling is.
Amen.
We
got to
know where the strongholds are.
Yeah.
We got to be able to get busy through fasting and prayer. Yeah. It's a season for it. It is the most humbling thing we can do. The Lord that we serve,
amen,
started his ministry with it. And if it's good enough for him, it's good enough for me.
Yeah.
If you're mad at me, I'll buy you a Burger King. But praise God, you guys.
Yes.
Praise God. The pastrami, he wants the pastrami. Yeah. I wish you give us a discount over there, man. I just want to give God all the praise and all the glory. There's just so much. That Larry King thing, look, when you get out, the enemy is the prince of the power of the world.
Oh, yeah.
I've done stuff on the radio and the paper. You see one, there's a lot of stuff. But God is faithful.
Yeah.
That Larry King show went international. And a few months after that, my wife died. 37 years. So I tell you, love why. Love her. I know. I got married a second time, because a lot of people don't realize that. She died. And on the way to the cemetery to bury her, I get a call from my brother that my mom died. I'm just saying, man, it ain't all bed and roses, but man, God is so good.
Amen.
God
Amen.
Is so good.
Amen.
He's faithful.
Amen.
And then he says, get up.
Come on.
Come on, get up. So I'm asking you guys to get up.
Come on.
Stand up. Please, stand up. Literally, stand up.
Soldier.
Stand up, guys. We're out here banging the boards, but can it get deeper? Can it in our personal life, in our personal walk, when we see that guy looking through the window when we're hungry? Can we see it? Can we still, or can we deal with it at all levels of our lives? Because we all have tremendous networks in this room, man. So I'm asking you to stand up. Look, you guys, I know there's a lot of need in here. I know there's a lot of needs. We all have needs, man. We all deal with issues, man, every day. But I guarantee you, man, if you begin to separate yourself and you say, Lord, today, for you, we don't got to wear it on our sleeve, like the word says, and look all downcast and all, what's wrong with all of not eating? Why? Because I'm fasting. No. I'm very pleased right now as I'm talking to you guys about this notion of fasting. Because I can guarantee you that will honor God if it's from your heart with a contrite heart. And you say, Lord, I want to get closer to you. Lord, I want to get closer to you. Lord, I'm desperate for you, Lord. I want to hear your voice more clearly. I need direction from you, Lord. I need you to direct my path, Lord. Oh, man. God will honor, and God will begin to move mountains, you guys, in your life. You'll see it in your home. You'll see it in your home. God's Spirit is on the move, you guys. Now, I don't know if anybody just came by chance and had never accepted the Lord, but I'm going to throw it out there. Because God called us to be soul winners. Number one, first and foremost, soul winners. Number one. And through the work that God's allowed us to do, we're out there every day. We get a chance to win souls.
Amen.
We Is anybody, can I just get by a raise of hands regarding the fasting? Regarding the fasting? Man, you guys, God, look at how universal it is in here. Men, how brilliant. And simple, but so simple. They have men from different churches, different denominations. Not the promotion of any one ministry. See, that's what has to happen. That's what I'm praying about for pastors. That we come together of one mind and one accord.
Amen.
One bride.
Amen.
For the honor and glory of God.
Amen.
It ain't about just me, myself, and I, and mine. No, it's about we and us.
Amen.
And as we come together, God, that's what this is, what this represents to me. I see this as an explosion waiting to happen.
That's right.
Because it's so pure. It's all about Jesus. It's all about the power of the living God. And it's about different men from different walks of life. And you brothers that are here that might not know the gang life, brother, but you have other skills and other attributes that comes to the table. What a powerful thing it is. It's powerful. I might be a great plumber, but man, I ain't going to touch nothing that's got electrical tied to it. So, Father, I just ask, is there anybody here that's never met the Lord? Everyone here knows the Lord? And Father, I'm just going to come before you right now, my God. By the power of the blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, Lord. I give you honor, I give you glory, I give you praise, for you deserve all the glory and all the honor, my God, and all the praise, my God. Yes, Lord, and I thank you for my wife, Lord. And I thank you for these men here, Lord. These men here that belong to you, they're your sons, my God. We're your servants, Lord. We're your warriors, Lord. You give us all that diversity, Lord, to abase and abound, to be both full and hungry, my God. Therefore, we're never in contempt, but we're content because you keep us satisfied, my God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. You said that you would take us from glory to glory, that you would never cease to amaze us, my God. We're standing on your word, and we're calling you on your word, Lord, for your word is a promise to us, Lord. You say you delight in your people who try, Lord, and we're trying, Lord. With everything we got, we're trying, Lord. Help us. And I bind the spirit of condemnation. For your word says, therefore, there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
They've been called according to his purpose. So we're about your purpose, Lord. But we have particular needs, Lord, that only you know. Oh, Holy Spirit, oh, we need you to ignite within us, Lord. Let this be a process of the igniting of the fuse. The fuse gets lit today. The fuse is going to explode into revival. In the San Fernando Valley. Revival, Lord. In and outside of the church. On the streets, on the corners, in the bushes, everywhere, Lord. Raise your people up. Raise your men up, Lord. Raise them up, Lord. Oh, Father, move, Holy Spirit. Move this morning, my God. Oh, I thank you, Lord. Oh, for those of us who have ministries in and out of the city, Lord. Go before them. Send your anointing, Lord. Oh, we lift them up, Father. In the name of your Son, Jesus, my God, I pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. You guys sit down for a second, real quick. So, thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So, I was given this stack to give to Blink, man. One of the guys here is a pretty crafty guy. His name's Jose Delgado. He makes walking sticks and canes, and he wanted me to present this to you, Blink.
Amen.
The first thing I said for most of you out there, wow, what color is it? That's behind us, Bo. So it says Men's Blue Line Men's Fellowship. Iron sharpens iron as one man sharpens another. Thank you for your consistent work in the community, Blinky, and impacting so many of us in here. I'm going to give you this, brother. Thank you. All right. You guys been to so many valleys, man. Praise God. Storms. Thank you, Blink. He's got to run to go see the police. Captain or chief? What is he?
Chief,
yeah, we talked about that this week. He's got a big meeting He's been personally invited with all these dignitaries. He's going to have a few minutes to talk to guys, and then he's got to run. You guys, take a minute to listen up real quick. So I want to thank the guys, the staff of Brewline, Alex and Craig and the rest of you, man. Everybody gives t-shirts, the guys that come up and set up and help out, man. I want to